Hello everyone, how are we all doing? I have my trading battle boxing gloves on, although I'm deeply regretting that because I'm probably not going to be able to take them off in any elegant fashion. Welcome to all you traders from around the world. We've got another great trading battle with you today. Unfortunately, the producers have decided to push my intellectual capacity to its peak by having two Michaels. So my ingenious solution today is to introduce them as Michael 1 and Michael 2, and we'll see how many times I get that the wrong way around. But hopefully we've got some great trades. We'll be trading some great causes today. So we're going to start by talking to Michael Weissman. How are you, Michael, today?
Did you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Great.
Okay, I'm sorry. I am wonderful. Thank you. How are you today?
Introduce yourself. Tell us a bit about you and your trading background for our audience at home.
Okay, sure. Well, I've been trading FX for about 20 years. 2001 or so is when I started. I was originally an equities trader for many years. I got into the FX business. And then since the FX, I got into multiple commodities. I trade futures. I trade commodities. I trade indexes. And trading FX for many, many years, self-taught. Spent a lot of money, a lot of years over the beginning. Pieced all of it together, and with a lot of trial and error and a couple of lost accounts, I found myself, kind of getting the hang of it. Finally, took a little time, and hence a career. And now I'm a software developer. We develop software for trading to help people trade.
Awesome, thank you very much, Michael 1. Michael 2, tell us a little bit about yourself as well.
Hello, Simon. I'm Michael, and I'm one of the joint founders of Funded Trading Plus, alongside Simon. Good. That's a battle in itself. Anyway, I started trading shortly after the huge downfall in 2008. The bob fell out of the market back then and destroyed a lot of things for me. My house value disappeared. My pension got decimated. And of course, I'd left that to professionals to do, people who told me they knew how to do trading. And it didn't turn out to be the case, did it? When you start seeing drops again now, you wonder whether or not we have similar scenarios going on. From there, went on to be one of the founders of Trojan Plus and been educating traders ever since. I fundamentally like to trade along as a swing trader alongside intraday trading, and hopefully the way that we work today gives some people out there some clues on how to trade and make some good profit for themselves.
Awesome. Thank you very much for that, Michael 1 and Michael 2. So we do have, as usual, three challenges that we'll be looking at. But of course, our traders are welcome to take any additional trades that they do see, where if they anything jumps to them in the market, because the markets are so volatile at the moment, which means there's so much opportunity to lose all your money trading, but also occasionally gain some money as well. So that's pretty interesting. I think we're going to jump straight into our first challenge that we'll see how our traders decide to interpret. And that first challenge is, if you had to place one trade on behalf of your family, what would it be? If you had to place one trade on behalf of your family, what would it be? Michael 1, what do you think to that?
Well, interestingly enough, I actually put on a trade a few minutes ago myself, and I went long silver. Silver has been getting decimated, and I think it's due for a rebound. I use my charts. Are you showing my charts?
We are, yes.
Okay, so this is my software, which indicates to me, and I'm looking at a 5-minute chart here, and this indicates to me where I see buying and selling power. Without getting into exactly how it works, I put on a long a little while ago. Price of 19.25. I have my stop down here, and I have my take profit up here at 19.43. And I'm going to just leave that, okay? Because the way I trade, very, very simply, is I don't trade for points. I trade for percentages. And that's how I teach my clients how to trade, is to trade for percentages. I like getting in the market and out of the market as soon as possible. I like to risk no more than 1% on any of my trades. And I'm only looking at the beginning for a 1.25 to 1 risk reward ratio. So I risk 1%. I'm looking to make 1.25%. And then I'll be out of the market and I'll move on to my next trade. Very, very simply. and I use my proprietary trading lines down here to give me an indication of if I'm going long, give me an idea of where I want to place my stop loss to give me the best opportunity to have this position extended itself. So I actually just put on a long on silver, and I honestly, I would do it again right now. It's a little bit, you know, I'm a little bit in the money on that trade, but I would do it again right now. So should I? Does that work?
You can take as many trades as you like. So this is on behalf of your family. So you've got got your stop loss below that market structure.
I have my stop loss here is below the market. Now I want to do what I want to do is. And interesting, you know, Michael and Slime, they're going to talk about their prop trading and in a few minutes. And so I'm gearing my trading towards trying to pass a prop trading audition. And so very, very simply, I set my software up, and this could be changed user to user, so that on every trade that I do, I'm risking 0.25% of my account. This is set up specifically to do a trade, to do a prop trading audition. I started 0.25%, and I'm only looking for a 0.3125% return. So, you know, that's what I'm going to go for. I'm going for a 1.25 to 1 risk reward, and I'm only risking 0.25% of the account. So let's just put in, well, that's how I'm working my trade. But I'm going to go long right now. Let me get gold, and I'm going to go long right now, and I am going to do 10 lots of gold. And I'm going to buy it. Hang on. And then I'm going to come back in. Okay. So I just bought it at 1928. And I'm going to come back in now. And I'm going to put a stop my stop is 1910. And so I'm going to go stop. I'm going to modify the order.
Go silver, go, Barnero is saying. So, but clearly, we've got some silver bulls in the chat as well. That's fantastic.
I'm very bullish on this long term. Now, I may, depending if it hits what I want. Let me just get my stop in 1901 for everybody, and my take profit I'm going to put in for right now is going to be 1943.1. And let me just modify that order. Okay, so. That's what I'm in right now. Okay. Perfect. And so I am long silver. You see it in my regular account here. This is actually an audition account, and that's why I'm using 0.25%. So I'm only risking, this is a $100,000 account. So I'm only risking $250 on this trade. My goal is to make about $325 in and out. That's my trade.
Perfect. Perfect. Well, thank you very much for that explanation. Michael, too, if you had to place one trade on behalf of your family, what would it be?
Well, when I looked at this task in the first place, it was angled around looking at my parents and my grandparents. What would they have done? And, you know, that's an interesting question. What would they have done rather than what would I do? So I'm going to bring my grandparents forward. So on one side, one of my grandfathers was a retailer, and on the other side, my other grandfather was a Davis Cup tennis player with Wimbledon going on. I think that's of interest to people. And he then went into medicine after that, and was very successful in both areas of life, very much so. So you got to say that my retailing grandfather, I think, would have been in the last few years trading Amazon, and frankly he would have done very, very well. He would have seen and understood. He was a person who pushed retail forward in the 30s and 40s and 50s, and so he would have understood that retail was going online, and he would have gone with it. Actually, I see Amazon with a really nice W over here. Now, I'm not going to trade this today because for our challenges, it doesn't stack up as a trade for a few days. But over the next year, this W pattern, I think, is likely to continue all the way up and up here, and over the next few years, carry on up. Amazon are building themselves all over the place. That's not investment advice. I don't give investment advice, but as a trader, I would be looking for trades longs in Amazon where and when I could there. And then the most obvious thing for my grandfather is to say, well, my other grandfather who went into medicine was, well, you know, you should be in Moderna. Now, Moderna are still up hugely from where they were. They've split their shares, actually, which is why they're down here. But actually, that's double where they were before the pandemic. Now, you know, 2 days the day they got approval for the vaccine, though, I think they were the first. We went long in live trading. My work certainly went long and have kept money in there ever since. And it has just done phenomenally well. And he would look at Moderna. I have got no doubt about that whatsoever. But of course, he was a tennis player at heart, an influencer. And right now, he'd be on Instagram talking about Wimbledon and all those things. And what do all the Instagram people do? Bitcoin. So let's look at that today.
I was going to say lie, but I guess Bitcoin is the more accurate one.
Absolutely. Now, this is the daily for Bitcoin. And as we can see, it's been absolutely hammered. And so the obvious thing is to go short. Now, we've got a 5-day trade here coming up rather than a what's going to happen in the next year or so. You know, quite easily, we could see Bitcoin and quite a lot of the cryptos going a long way down yet. But we've got a bit of a turning point here. And I think I'm just gonna take a 5-day risk on this with stop below here and just stick along straight on Bitcoin and say, thanks, Grandpa.
Yeah, I think I'm probably short-term bullish on Bitcoin as well, and I think for the silver trade as well, I think that also certainly looks bullish on that 5-minute time frame as well. So there are two trades I would have taken, which is probably a big red flag for both of you. You should immediately go to your position, as I am the reverse indicator in that respect. So yeah, that's pretty interesting. Michael Wong, what else are you sort of interested in at the market then? Are you looking at any sort of macroeconomic situation that's interesting you? What do you see on the horizon that you think would be of benefit for our
country? You know, it's funny. What I've learned over 20 years is macroeconomics mean very little to me. Mm. Now, I'm not saying I don't follow it, and I'm happy to give you my thoughts on it, okay? But as far as the way I trade and come in every day, macroeconomics are just totally immaterial to me because I can have a feeling for what's happening. And as I'll tell you now, as I think the U.S. is heading into a recession, I think it's unavoidable. I think the rest of the world is probably going to follow suit. I think if you look at commodities prices, they've been getting devastated over the last month or so, in particular copper. Copper is a significant leading indicator for potential recessions, and copper is getting destroyed. Copper is one of the primary funding, you know, building materials that go into absolutely everything. And when copper is getting destroyed, that's not a good indication for what the future holds. So I think the markets are going to go down. I think bonds are going to go down. I love gold and silver once they finally shake out whoever the weak hands are now, because they really make an attempt at shaking them out, because I think gold and silver should both be higher. And I would be a long-term holder of gold and silver, but I don't trade long-term because, you know, the market is just, it is what it is. It's news-driven. It's volatile. You have to protect your account at all times. And I anything I would do today, even let's just say Wednesday today, any trading I do, my goal is to be out for sure, probably the end of the day today, the worst tomorrow, and being flat come non-farm payrolls on Friday, because you know, it doesn't really matter. You get a number that's good or bad in the market. Gets very volatile for a short period of time. It could wipe out your trade. I don't like trading under those conditions. So I have macro, you know, again, I think the markets are going to go down. I think the indexes are going to go down, but it doesn't mean they can't fly higher tomorrow or the next day. And therefore, I wouldn't, you know, I don't trade like that. I'll trade for what I think is happening today based on what I see happening in my charts, based on the money flow that I see happening. So, you know, those are my, you know, my general economic thoughts, but they mean nothing to me as I make a trade today.
Because you're too short term, essentially.
Too short term. I'll trade 5 minute and 15 minute charts. Listen, you know, my opinion on the market, it depends on what you want to get out of the market, okay, as a trader. So if you're an investor, that's one thing. You can swing trade, you can longer term trade. If you're a day trader, if you're trying to make a living out of this, the financial information, the math behind it all means you have to be shorter term, you have to get in and out of the market, you have to make your points, you have to get your return on your assets, and then you have to move on to the next trade. And the way to make a lot of money, or the guys that you hear who are day traders and who are successful day traders, you know, the reality is a successful day trader, if he makes 20% a month, he's good. That's good. He's good. And, you know, I'm not saying you can't make 20, you can't make 30, maybe some people even make more, but that's good. And so that's what, you know, we teach our people to do, and that's what we strive to do with our trading. And that's where I get back to, we trade on percentages, and therefore I want to get in my trade, I want to get out of my trade. The way I trade, the more trades you do, the better you will do, because it's just a matter of probabilities. So if we could teach you how to put the probabilities on your side, even let's just say 60-40 or 55, you know, 45, just slightly on your side, and you use good risk management, like the 1.25 to 1 that I'm talking about, then all of this, that's how you get in, you get out, you either lose your 1% or you make your 1.25%, you turn your money fast, and you move on to the next trade. And time will build up your account if you can maintain a 50% win-loss ratio and a 1.25 to 1 risk reward. And that's how I teach trading every day.
Thank you. Excellent for that insight. Yeah, I mean, a lot of core principles come out of there. Sensible risk management. You know, news trading can be very unpredictable and volatile. If it comes out good, it can go down. If it comes out bad, it can go up. I think that's a very early lesson that traders do acknowledge, is the news trading can be very unpredictable in that respect. Michael, too, what are your thoughts on the current sort of global outlook, macro sort of economic political situation?
Well, we're seeing an awful lot going on. And inflation will continue. That there's absolutely no doubt whatsoever that inflation will not continue. We could be looking at recessions all over all of the developed countries. It was led very much by by Putin, probably, you know, a year ago when he started squeezing up on the pipes on gas, and that was a signal that there was other things to come along. And that started the inflation, and that's on top of the drive for people having more money and wanting to spend previously. I think that the economics of it isn't that relevant, but I wouldn't be surprised to see recession across the board. But just like Michael, I don't care about that when I'm looking at a 5 minute trade. I mean, that doesn't matter. Makes no difference. You have to take the setup as the setup and not be driven by some of the fundamentals that might be going, I'm scared of this. The markets are going to go down. Well, they may well be going down. And you know, if your setup takes you down, go down with it. Take some profit, leave something on. That's for your fundamental. But your setup has to come first. Very much so. Setup comes first entirely. Now, when I look at the markets I've got up in front of me right now at this moment, I've got just a few markets up, just so I can just see generally what's been going on. And over here, I've got euro, dollar, pound, dollar, and gold. And we can see some, these are on daily charts at this moment, just so I can get some idea of what's going on. And we can see some big downward movement, big downward movement, big downward movement. And this is all about strength of the dollar against all these other currencies. And it does look likely that the ECB won't do a certain amount of upping of their interest rates, and that against the fact that the Fed has upped interest rates is possibly the reason that this is pulling down. When we're looking for trades on this, do I want to go with trend or do I want to jump back? Are we looking at our next trade at this point, Simon?
5 minute time frame trade, not just yet, but you can. Okay. We'll revisit that in a moment.
Yeah, sure. So I would now, if you're looking for momentum, then ideally the thing to do is to look for where markets are actually moving, like these ones, and then go into them and look for pullback trades to go short. So ideally you go into the time frame and say, right, where do I want it to pull back to? So here's a daily level on euro dollar. If the market came back up here, then you'd want to get short again. We've got a sort of similar level not that far away on pound dollar, where if it comes up there, you want to probably take a shorter term short back down. It doesn't mean it's going to get all the way to the bottom here, but if it does break through, it may well go twice as far. So you know, you come back on time frames and start to do your intraday trading on that basis, and that's the sort of thing that I would be looking for. I don't believe at this moment it's a good idea to be trying to predict where the markets are going to be in 6 months' time. At this moment, that is not really that knowable. The momentum is down on many of the markets, and probably you should stay with that until the end. Now, the other important thing about looking at these candles is that a lot of traders look at them and go, oh, wow, they've gone down. They're going to go up again. The most common thing for a market to do at the bottom of where it gets to is not bounce straight back up. The most common thing for a market to do at that point is to go sideways. So actually, you can make lots of money in sideways markets. That's not the point. The point is, don't think it's going to go flying back all the way back up again. And people make this mistake all the time, and they hold the trades and go, oh, but then I lost all that profit. Oh, I lost all that profit. Oh, markets come down, they go sideways, and then they go back up a bit more, and then sideways. They may come down again and sideways, but sideways actually is a trader's skill to understand and know when that's likely to come about. And you can make money within the sideways markets by finding tops and bottoms and just simply coming off those in your intraday market, in your intraday trading.
Awesome. Thank you very much for that analysis. I've got a feeling we might be revisiting some of those with our next challenge. So we're going to go on to challenge two now, as this stream is certainly flying by at the moment. And challenge two is place a trade using only the 5 minute time frames. I don't care if you've already done that. You're going to have to do another one. So, Michael, one, what are you looking at to trade on the 5 minute time frame?
One second. Okay. Now I got to go find another 5 minute chart after. Let's take a quick look. So I did silver, which was already a 5 minute chart.
Yeah.
Take a look. Do a quick. Boy, oil looks weak again. You got to bear with me. Boy.
Would you like a couple of minutes? I can pop to Michael too.
Yeah, but go ahead. I'm sorry. And I'll pull out a quick 5 minute in a minute.
Yeah, no problem.
If Michael's ready, sure. Go ahead.
Michael too. Are you more ready?
I'm going to pick one of the markets right in front of me and then look at it and then put a trade on it. And we'll just go straight into it. Toss your coin, Simon. Euro dollar, pound dollar, or gold? Which one do you want me to go on?
I frankly
don't care.
We've got a vested interest in pound dollar getting smashed, haven't we? So I hope that carries on going down.
It carries on going down?
Well, of course, for obvious reasons.
Yes, sure. Okay. So basically, vested interest in it going down. I don't want to think like that. I have to think about what's it actually doing. So let's just come back on the time a little bit. This is a daily chart, and what I can see is that we are really, really low. you know, in the last few years, the last time it was down, it got anywhere near being any lower was in 2020. And that, guess what that was? I'll give, you know, the first person in the chat to say, what gave that big drop down there in 2020? Please.
Pound short, the wrong answer.
Are you looking for comments?
Yes, yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's for all you out there. So, you know, fundamentally, this is quite a big low. So let's head back into the hourly chart and see what we've got going on in there at this moment. What we have is a clear driving pattern, sort of like this coming down. And I am interested, it's got back above this point here. So I'm interested in it possibly coming up a bit higher. Now I could draw a fib on this area here and make targets on that there. So that's the hour. Now I'm going to go into the 5 minutes on that and see what we've got within that structure to see whether a trade makes sense. So now on the 5 minute chart, and I could either put in a trade instantly or wait for a pullback, probably not that far, something like that there would give you a trade. But I'm just going to go long on this 5 minute chart on pound dollar, and Simon wants me to go short.
No, to be fair, on a 5 minute, I'm bullish as well.
Yes, it's just holding within this piece of structure here. If it gets through here, then we could go a bit higher, possibly up to sort of this level here in there, 1.9420. I wouldn't really be looking for a lot more than that on this trade. I would take some profit off here and then leaving a portion on stop break even or trail the stop up for a further up. But, you know, we could get this here and then this here and then this there.
Just of note, the US opens in 2 minutes as well.
Yes.
Just to add a bit more complexity, the US stock market's about to open. But yeah, I mean, the pound has been hammered since pretty much Brexit, hasn't it? When the UK left the European Union, the pound got hammered. Then it went down to, I think, £1.16 on the back of COVID, which I think was the lowest it's been since 1986 or something like that, nearly as old as me. You know, the vested interest I have is I get paid and everything in dollars. So a strong dollar a week pound is fantastic for me, even if it does contribute to the horrendous fuel costs that we need to fill our cars with at the moment. So you're looking for a cable trade, Michael, you update, Michael two, your updates in a moment. Michael one, have you had time to find another trade on the 5 minute
chart?
Yeah,
you know what? I'm still a metals fan. So I have a trade in on silver and I'm going to put another one in on gold right now. All right. And so this is my 5 minute chart. Just, you know, briefly what I see, this pattern right down here, we call that a new directional indicator at the low of the day. This line right here, just using my software, is what we call is a temporary line. That is the 5 minute chart. So this will confirm. If you can wait 2 seconds, I'd love to see, let's see, 9:29. I don't know how many seconds we have to go. What will happen at 9:30, assuming we don't take out this low, this line will confirm. It will turn solid red, and it will give me a little bit more indication of what I want to do. So I'm looking to go long gold. So hang on, and I'll tell you where. And I'm also going to do 10 lots on gold. And I'd love to see us hold on. Yeah, the line confirms. I just went long. Okay, I just went long gold. Oh, except it's moving. Oh, shit.
Okay. We're hearing all the noises from MetaTrader.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Okay, so hold on.
You're getting a whole routine.
Yeah, hold on. I can't. I don't have enough money for that. Hold on.
10 lots is a fraction larger.
So I'm going to put 5 lots.
There we go.
Not enough money because I put 10 lots on before. Okay, so hang on. So here I'm going to do 2 lots. Let's see what happens. Oh, Voice move. All right, hold on.
Sounds like I'm on a Star Wars set.
So now you know what. So what I'm going to do is I am going to sell. Hold on. Okay, I just closed half of my silver position from before for some profit. Okay, and loosen up some money here to now buy. Gold is moving, but I'm still going to buy gold. Hold on. Let's see if I could buy three lots of gold. Wow, it's moving. Okay. So I got three lots of gold. Let's see. And I got in at 1764.78. And I am going to put my stop below 1759. So I'm going to put my stop at 1750. Just modify the position right now. 1750. Okay. So.
All right. Well, let you put that on your other account as well, the one that we're displaying.
Oh, okay. So you know what? Well, I'm not going to put it on this account right this second. Okay. I made it on the other account. So I'm in long at 1764.78, and I cut my silver position down in half from 10 lots to 5 lots, and I took some profits.
Awesome. Michael, did you manage to get a trade on cable?
I did, yes. Yeah.
Cool, right, let me blindside you. Find me something on one of the indices.
One of the indices, okay. Well, yeah, you know, I'm straight now. I'll go straight into
Oh, look at your profit.
Yep, just 1 second.
Oh man, that is volatile.
Yeah, no problem. Very volatile.
So the reason I'm asking Michael to have a look at one of the indices, Michael 2, should I say, is the stock market, they're some of the most heavily traded assets. We see gold is one of the most heavily traded assets, but quickly followed by the likes of the NASDAQ, the US 30, and the S&P 500. The S&P 500 is majorly traded on the futures exchange, the ES or the MES, as you may well know it as. But the volumes that we see of our proprietary trading firm, huge amount of gold, huge amount of NASDAQ. So they're clearly the sort of markets that retail traders are very interested in. Gold is very surprising. And when it comes to sort of cryptocurrencies, it's the obvious ones. Bitcoin has about 70% of the volume, and then it tends to be Ethereum, and then it drops off quite rapidly as well. So you do tend to see the same sort of markets are the most popular and heavily traded markets. What are you looking at the moment then, Michael?
Okay, I've just pulled up daily on NASDAQ, and, you know, are my hand-drawn lines...
Beautiful lines.
Any worse than a straight drawn line? Question for you guys out there. Which is better for your trading? What's better for your understanding of the market? I'd really like an answer to that question. Do you think that I should be putting a straight line here? Or do you think I should be putting I can be happy with my you know, these are clear levels that the market's showing us. Should they be straight lines? Or am I putting across by scribbling on the chart that actually markets don't conform to a straight line? They come up to areas, they're zones. You need to accept that they're zones. And too many traders don't get that. They just get too stuck into this is the level. It's more likely to be a zone, an area. So actually, when you're looking at charts, don't be afraid of just going, it's in here. You know, that's the point that I want to make out of that. So NASDAQ, let's drop down from daily into we are poking over now. It's nice and early in the NASDAQ market, isn't it? It really is for today. Buy.
Yeah. I think I'd probably agree with that one as well. NASDAQ can be a little sod when it comes to when it comes to faking out and stuff like that. But yeah, certainly it looks like there's a degree of recovery. There's higher highs and higher lows on the NASDAQ at the moment. So you've got a NASDAQ trade on as well. Excellent. Hopefully that won't come on the third challenge. If not, we'll have to redo it. But that's no problem whatsoever. Michael, one, have you got any thoughts on any of the indices? Do you trade any of the indices?
I trade them all.
Perfect. Any trade ideas on them?
Let's take a quick look. So I got NASDAQ. And let me look at S&P 500. Let's just take a quick look. If anything looks good. The S&P looks like it, you know, wants to go. So, yeah, I'm going to go long S&Ps for right now. And I think you can go long S&P with a stop loss. Well, stop loss is really should be down here. I could put the stop loss right here and limit the risk. And okay, so let's do the S&Ps, and I'm going to go long. I'm not going to wait around. I'm going to go long right here, and I'm going to do three lots. Let's see if I have the room for that.
Okay, so you're looking to get long on the S&P. Relatively similar trade to Michael there, although the NASDAQ doesn't necessarily correlate with the S&P.
Yeah. I just went long. Yeah, I just went long. And I'm going to hold this one a little bit. So I'm going to put my stop loss. Let's put my stop loss over here. Let's see. So that's about 37.99. So, okay. So I'm going to put my stop loss in at about 37.95 on this order. And, okay. So that's it. Okay. So I'm in at 38.31. And I got a stop loss of 37.95, and I didn't put in a take profit yet. This is one I'm going to watch. I'm going to give a little bit of room, and I'm going to try and monitor it. That's
Excellent. So again, that's on the 5-minute chart. So I managed to blind Michael one and two succeeded very well in me blindside moving index trade. So unfortunately, these gentlemen are obviously very familiar with those types of trades. So we have some additional trades on as well. Michael, too, give me a concise sort of tip for one tip for traders who are sort of wanting to get into trading.
Well, as trading educators, we used to say, don't trade a demo account. You don't get the same feeling. You don't get the same emotions, and it's emotions of that drive how you trade. It has to be real money. The problem with putting on trades that are, you know, when you've only got a pot of $500, £1,000 or that sort of size of amount of money to put in the markets, and you're trading at sensible sizes, making $10 a day isn't going to cut it for you. You don't get the emotional issues or anything else with it. And you would probably end up just getting bored and taking risky trades and then just losing the money you've put in it. And this is how accounts get burnt. So you really need a greater level of capital. So, you know, go with a smaller size funded trading firm's account. And that could give you significant amounts of money and help you along the way.
Yeah, absolutely. Michael, I'm going to come to you as well. Just try and keep it short because we're going to need to jump into our next challenge. So 30 seconds, a tip for aspiring traders.
Yeah, the biggest thing that I can tell people is that they have to understand the math behind trading and be realistic about what their goals are. And I started to mention it to you before, okay? A very good day trader, in my opinion, and from my experience and from talking to a number of people, okay, if you can make 20% a month or 30% a month, I mean, you're a superstar, okay, on a consistent basis, if you manage your money well and you can get those kind of returns, you're a superstar. So you need to realize that if you want to become a trader and you have $1,000 or $2,000 or $3,000 or $5,000, sure, you can learn how to trade. And yeah, you can learn how to be profitable, but you really can't make any money. It's just not possible. So you have to be prepared going in to understand what the opportunity is, that even if you become very, very good at your craft, You need an account size that would make warrant the ability to be able to make enough money to warrant spending the amount of time that you have to spend doing this to become good at it. So you got to understand the math, the realities of the business, the realities of how to make money trading, how to manage your money is critical. And then picking out trades is, I don't want to say is secondary, but you have to understand the business. You have to understand the process of how to build an account and make money by while managing it to a point where you stay in business, because that your trading account is your asset. It's your business. Without your trading account, you're out of business. So you must protect your trading account at all times. That goes without saying. And you got to do that while at the same time taking enough risk in order to warrant being a trader so that you can make a return. That's it.
Perfect. Thank you very much for that. Right. We're going to go into our final challenge. We're going to start off with Michael 2, and that is going to be a spin the wheel that's sort of randomly selecting a asset to trade. And then what we're going to do, jump over to Michael 1, get him to select it to give Michael 2 a tiny bit of time in order for him to be able to figure out a trade. So spin the wheel and trade the asset. Let's go to Michael 2 first. Got sound effects.
What are you going to give me? What would be the worst one? What would the one I wouldn't want? Pound dollar.
Pound.
Yeah.
We need to re-spin. He's already got re-spin pound dollar. It. Re-spin. We're running pointless. A tight ship here.
Yeah. It was always going to be that, wasn't it?
It was always going to be up.
Don't stop on the NASDAQ.
That's oil.
Have I got
all right,
oil up?
Okay, we're going to give you a minute to figure out oil. Let's move to Michael 1 and get him to spin the wheel as well. We want to give Michael 2 a tiny chance to get figure out a trade.
All right, I spin the wheel? Okay. Come on, baby. Come on. It's one of the figures one I just did, right? Was that gold?
No, that is Bitcoin. Are you already in on Bitcoin?
No, I didn't do Bitcoin yet.
Oh, no, it's gold. He's already in gold. Spin again.
I'm already in gold and silver.
What are the chances we're picking the assets?
Yeah, exactly. And don't pick oil.
I like this part. All right, let's have a look.
Anything else?
All right, so you're going to get dollar yen. Okay, right, Michael, we've got dollar yen. Have a look at dollar yen. We're going to go to Michael, too. Have you found an opportunity on gold?
But so oils,
oil, what you oil, that out. One. Oh, so we have had today, right at the end.
We have had big drop downs on oil. We do have structure to support it going sideways, stroke bouncing in this area. There is definitely structure in this area. I mean, it could come all the way down further, but structure does exist in this area for some support. And so I'm going to pop to the hour, and what we can see is that it has held here twice, double bottomed on the hour at this moment. So let's go into that 15 minute. And as we can see, it's holding. I'm going to go long oil.
Awesome. So you're going to go long oil. Fantastic. I mean, oil price going down is probably good. Not that the retailers will in any way, shape or form decide to add value or sort of reduce the price of gas, as we should say, for our international audiences. So you're going to go long on oil. Excellent. Michael 1, what are you going to do on Japanese, on dollar yen, I beg your pardon?
Okay, so I'm kind of taking a look here. Obviously, dollar yen has been flying high. This is my daily chart. You know, nothing but these red lines building, which tells me I want to be long. My stop would be over here if I was looking at a long-term trade. But that's a long way away. So we're priced at 135, and my stop would have to be at 131. So I don't really like doing trades where I have to give that long, that much of a stop. So let's look at the 4 hour. It's kind of meandering. I'm looking to see if I could get into something that'll give me a better idea. So on the hour charts, it's obviously coming down, but we got some pretty big support down here. Let me see what's turning up here. It still wants to go down. Well, everything power is going down. Still wants to go down. I'm sorry. Still wants to go down. Everything wants to go down, but I have what's called, you know what? This is interesting. I am going to go long, believe it or not. Even though everything is against me, this is we call this a directional indicator. So I'm looking at a 5 minute chart, and I'm going to see if this, hang on a second. Oops. Oh, it's moving. I was going to go long, and here it goes. Okay, so it's going to give 1 second. Let's just see something to try again. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, okay, I'm going to... I'm missing the trade. Hang on 1 second, guys. Missing the trade. It's going... It's going long. I'm going to just buy it. All right. I wouldn't buy it here, ideally, to be honest with you. I would wait, you know, down here was a better buy. But let's just say, you know, I bought it. Okay. So actually, I bought it on my own account. And now let me go back and buy it here. Dollar yen. Hang on. Let me find dollar yen.
So you're going to stick on the 8 cap count. Oh, wow. Brilliant.
I didn't do it any. I'm going long right now. Another 3 lots. Okay, I just went long. Okay.
Okay.
So I just went long dollar yen on the 8 cap account. Oh, hold on. Maybe not. I don't know. All right, let me go. I'll do 1 lot here. Hold on. 1 lot. Okay.
Let's switch back to. We're running out of time here. So let's switch back to Michael too. While you put that.
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead. I am.
Yeah, you stick that trade on. Right.
Yeah, I got to. You know what it is? I'm going to close out my.
We'll let you sort that.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to close. All right. Oops. I'm going to close out the rest of my silver trade. Okay. And make some money. And now I'm going to go long dollar yen at 3 lots. Bye. Except, okay. All right. I actually closed out of my silver trade. Which is fine. So I'm done.
Okay, great. We got it. We're pushed time. Right. To Michael 2, please.
Done.
Perfect. Michael 2, tell us about the charity. 35.17.
I'm in on dollar yen. Okay.
I'm trying to earn myself that 20 to 30% per month that Michael 1 was talking about. And I'm sure Goldman Sachs will be snapping me up very quickly. They probably haven't been able to. Nobody probably has been able to make 20, 30% in a month in a very, very long ever. And I think it's important not to give. I'll move on from that.
That's okay. If I may rebut, it's very possible I do it, and I know people who do it, and we train people to do it.
So. I'm gonna box you both in a minute if you don't shut up.
Yeah,
Michael, okay. Too. Tell us about your charity.
Oh, Spinal Injuries Association does a huge amount of work in the UK for helping those spinally injured to rehabilitate and get back on into life and into life generally. A very important charity in the UK. And at the moment with this NASDAQ trade, they're not going to be getting a lot. But what we do find in the first half hour of the open of index markets do go up and down within a range. And then you've really got to wait for that first half hour to end, and then we can get a move out of the half hour, which could either be up or down. If it comes down, I'm history, and Michael 1 will be winning this easily. I have taken good profits out of the pound dollar trade, so that's looking pretty good on that side of the equation. But on the right hand side of the equation, is not looking good at this moment. But that could turn around in 15-20 minutes time.
So the NASDAQ's been a little sodden doing a fake out like we discussed earlier. There we go. That's a nice word for our global audience. Michael 1, tell us which charity you're playing for, please.
All right. So I'm playing for Bobby and the Strays. And Bobby and the Strays is a very well-known animal rescue facility out near where we live. And we've been very involved with them for a number of years at this point. We're big animal lovers. My wife and I, we've had many, many dogs, other pets. They've always been a very big part of our family. We've rescued dogs, we've adopted dogs, we've bought dogs, and these rescue places just can need all the help that we can give them, because they're doing a wonderful, wonderful thing, and it's very dear to our hearts.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much for that. Right. We are pretty much bang on the 50 minutes. So thank you for all of you who have joined us today. Please do subscribe to this YouTube channel. There's going to be plenty more fantastic trading battles coming up for people who trade everything from crypto to FX to gold to everything in between. So you can always learn a lot from every single stream. Thank you to Michael 1 and Michael 2 for all the information and debate we've had today and all the trades you've got. We don't usually get this many trades on, so it'll be great to see in 5 days' time who comes out victorious and who raises money for those fantastic charities. So from everyone here at the Trading Battle, for wherever you are in the world, have a fantastic morning, evening, and night, and we will see you next time. Thank you very much for watching.